وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له إقراراً بربوبيته وإرغاماً لمن جحد به وكفر، والصلاة والسلام على خير البشر النبي الأمي الذي دعانا إلى صفاء القلوب ونقاء الصدور وطهارة النفوس، صلاة وسلاما دائمين متلازمين عليك سيدي يا رسول الله. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله، أوصيكم ونفسي الخاطئة بتقوى الله وطاعته، إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون. يقول ربنا تبارك وتعالى في كتابه الكريم: يا أيها الناس إنا خلقناكم من ذكر وأنثى وجعلناكم شعوبا وقبائل لتعارفوا إن أكرمكم عند الله أتقاكم. Dear brothers and sisters, I begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He deserves to be praised, and glorifying Him, and thanking Him for the countless blessings that He has given us. We thank Him for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We thank Him for the Quran, which is guidance, hidayah in nas. And I bear witness that there is no God except Allah. And I also bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah and his servant. The person who is guided on the straight path of Islam, no one can misguide that person. No one can lead that person astray. And the one who is not guided on the right path of Islam, no one can guide that person except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout His guidance and throughout His mercy. Dear brothers and sisters, during this Friday khutbah, I tend to talk about some of the categories of the people within this ummah that need to reform themselves. Otherwise, the way how it is going, with the mentality of certain people, this ummah will see nothing but harm. So therefore, in order for us to get better, in order for this ummah to see better days ahead, we need to be aware of certain things that exist within our own communities around the Muslim world and within our own selves, that we need to pinpoint these problematic characters and progress, move forward, better ourselves. وَأَحْسِنُوا. The Quran talks about reforming ourselves in a way that we better ourselves. Today, it should not be the same as tomorrow. Tomorrow, it should not be the same as today. Or tomorrow should not be the same as after tomorrow. So every day requires change. إن الله يحب المحسنين. In various verses in the Quran, it is stated that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those people who progress. Loves those people who progress. Loves those who better themselves. And it was never a part of this ummah to remain at the same place Islamic civilizations around the world, they all progress. And we see the progress years, centuries ago. However, in the last centuries, we are remaining not only in one level, but sometimes we are going backward. And this does not help this ummah, but it gets us more and more in trouble. Therefore, I do not, since I'm talking about these negative characteristics that we do possess in our communities and around, I do not intend to tell you that I am the best. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given me the ability to at least recognize, and we all should work, including me, myself, and every one of us, in order to improve. As Yusuf alayhi salam, even though he was a prophet of God, he said, وَمَا أُبَرِّئُ نَفْسِي. I do not tend to be an angel, I do not tend to say that I am the best. إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَ بِالسُّوءِ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي. A part of this nafs indeed has some bad, or it possesses some bad characteristics, some bad things, except that part of the nafs that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given mercy to. So without further ado, one of the major problems that we see in our ummah nowadays is people who assume, people of dhan, assuming. This has become widespread all over the Muslim world. We do not see the facts. We do not analyze things, but we jump right away into conclusion simply because we assume things. This is widespread, as I said, all over the places. إِنْ يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ. إِنْ يَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا الظَّنَّ. وَإِنَّ الظَّنَّ لَا يُغْنِي مِنَ الْحَقِّ شَيْئًا. The assumption, what people assume, it is not necessarily a representative of the truth. Does not necessarily represent the truth. When you think, when you assume about others, does not necessarily represent the truth. And as a matter of fact, this characteristic of assuming for others is a characteristic that was entitled to the non-believers. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنْ يَتَّبِعُونَ, they are following, he refers to the non-believers, Quran, in Surah Al-Najm and many other places, and other places of Quran. They are following the assumption when it comes to worship other deities beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When it comes to consider religion, consider rules of their society, things that have nothing to do with reality. Instead of worshipping Allah, they are worshipping stones. Instead of treating the woman right, they are treating them wrong. So this is all based on what? It is based on dhan. It is based on assumption. إِنْ يَتَّبِعُونَ. These are people who are following the assumption. However, as I said, in our communities, people in our communities, they have fallen victims of assumption. Victims of dhan. And we are not an ummah of dhan. We are an ummah of proofs, facts. We don't talk with assumption, but we talk with facts. We do not blame somebody based because we think that perhaps maybe I don't look because he doesn't look good, so he's not a good person. Or because I saw him sitting with another person who I don't like, so automatically he's bad too. All of this is done. All of this is assumption. And this is indeed killing us. We have to get rid of this, and we have to stick Another problem that we see is with the people who are reactionary. It is needed sometimes, definitely. However, we have become people of reactionary every time. And Islam and the examples of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam teach us not to be people, reactionary people, but to be from those people who move forward. What I'm trying to say is, the moment something happens, we react right away. And we base that reaction sometimes on assumption, and sometimes it is a hurry reaction without thinking too much, without using the wisdom too much, without the hikmah, but we react right away because there is no patience, there is no sabr, there is no intellectual mind. Take a look at the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was not a person, he was not a reactionary person. Rasulullah was not a reactionary person. When people came at the Hudaybiyah Treaty, the Pact of Hudaybiyah, the mushriks from Mecca, they sent a representative who said in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was about to write and to sign this treaty. And you know very well that a part of this treaty was that Muslims, for example, just give you an example, if somebody becomes a Muslim in Mecca, and that Muslim goes and migrates to the city of Medina, Muslims of Medina, they have to return this person back to Mecca. But if a person who leaves Islam and travels back to Mecca from Medina, that person can stay in, travels from Medina back to Mecca, that person can stay in Mecca. He doesn't have to go back again to Medina. So there were unfair rules. However, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam signed this treaty. And Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu and some other companions, they really felt uncomfortable. They went in front of the Prophet, Umar went in front of the Prophet and he said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not return the bad with bad. He did not return something bad with bad. When he was in the city of Taif, you remember very well the story from the seerah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even little children, they throw rocks at him. And he was bleeding. And he did not even complain about that. As long as you are pleased with me, he's directing his words to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As long as you, that's what it matters to me, your pleasure. And the angel came down and telling him, are you ready? We can have these two mountains in between the city of Taif collapse over them. Prophet was not a reactionary man. He did not say, yes, let's do it. That's being reactionary right away. Man, they're about to kill you. You are bleeding. You want the revenge. He stood back. He said, no. Perhaps Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to guide these people to Islam. They will be guided to Islam. Again, that's what happened later on. You know very well that the city of Taif became a Muslim. They accepted Islam. Brothers and sisters, if Muslims would have been reactionary people, we would not even have Islam as we have it nowadays. We are commanded to look forward. We try right away, if somebody tells us something, we want to get it back. We want to get back to it. Because we think that it is a part of manhood. We think that it is a part of being a man. Revenge. Saying it back, you know, talking back to the people. And according to the hadith, we understand that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that laysa shadeedu man ghalaba an-nas. It's not the powerful person, the one who beats the others up. The one who shows the muscles to the others. That is not the powerful man. But the powerful one is the one who has control, full control over himself, over his nafs. He is able to control himself. He is able to control his anger. He has sabr. He has mastered his own ego, his own nafs. That is the man. That is manhood. And sometimes, let me give you another perspective as well. Even when somebody does something good, right? Somebody does something good, we try to do something good to that person as well, which is very good. But we don't do that good thing unless we receive something good. This is the problem too. We have to be the initiators of good. We have to be you, me, every one of us. We have to be the initiator. Don't let the others come to you first with something good. You be the first one to do that. Oh, the brother did not come to visit me, so why should I go and visit him? No, no, you be the first one to go and visit him. Shaykh, I have a brother who I go all the time and visit, he never comes. Continue doing it. I have a friend who I meet him often and I invite him for a tea. He doesn't invite me often. Why should I go? Continue doing it. I have donated for the masjid and I have done this, but people in season they do not appreciate. Continue doing it. Because you are not doing it for the people. You are doing it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to receive the reward of that action. And if you are looking for the reward in the year after, then don't look for the appreciation of the people. So try to always be an initiator of the good things. فَاسْتَبِقُوا الْخَيْرَاتِ. Race for the performance of the good deeds. Race with each other, compete with each other. The Qur'an tells us. During the time of Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, there was a man who came to him and gave him a gift. He said, Ya Imam, here is the gift, take it. And the Imam, later on, sometimes later, he sends him a gift that had a value 10 times more. about you thinking of me during a time when I forgot about you. That's what counts. No matter what I get back to you, it's not a big deal, in other words. But what counts is that you thought of me in a time that I forgot about you. These are the examples of the Tabi'een, the followers of the companions, the example of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that we have to follow. Brothers and sisters, also another problematic character that we see in our Ummah is being judgmental. Judging the people right away, being judgmental. And a lot of it comes from assumption, when we assume, as I mentioned earlier, but also as a part of being arrogant, as a part of having an arrogant mindset, where you have a person saying, me, simply because I belong to a certain family, or me, because I have this kind of a job, me, because I possess this much of money, status, fame, and you look upon the others down. This is the reason, this can be a reason, the arrogance can be a reason for you to be judgmental about others. Too much pride. There's too much kibber. There's too much pride all over. Everybody says, me, me, me. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith that is narrated by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud in the Sahih Muslim and also in the Jannah of Imam al-Tirmidhi. He says, لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. None of you is going to enter paradise. Even if you have the smallest amount of kibr in your heart, will not be able to enter paradise. And the kibr, as I said, is right and left. Everybody is a scholar. Everybody is a learned man. Everybody is so high. And, you know, they don't think that they might have shortcomings. And then one person tells Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, O Prophet of God, one may love his clothes to look good and his shoes to look good. So in other words, he's saying, is this a part of the pride? Is this the pride that we're talking about? And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Allah is beautiful, he says, and he loves beauty. Arrogance is rejecting the truth and looking at the others down. He is defining for us what arrogance is. Rejecting the truth. Instead of looking at the fact, you are the truth to assume. So this is rejecting the truth. And then, he says, looking at the others down. Like they're nothing. They're uneducated. And brothers and sisters, indeed, a lot of people, they do not possess the ability to understand others. When you talk to the people, when you talk to your fellow Muslims, and even non-Muslims, you have to understand their background. You have to understand why are they saying certain things. What is it relating to? Where do they come from? What is the culture behind that? You have to take things into perspective when you talk to the other people. And sometimes we see the actions of others who are sinning. However, we fail to see our own actions. You might have a brother who is judging another person who doesn't perform the prayers. Say there's a man who doesn't pray. And you judge right away. You say that person is very weak and they're indeed not performing the prayer. That is wrong. That is neglecting the faraid. However, you are ready to label that person and put that person down immediately and think of yourself high. And think high of yourself. Why? Because you are performing the prayer. However, you are not taking into consideration that you may be a big liar, that you may be a big cheater, that when you do business you are the worst, that you are the worst husband, or you may be the worst wife. You don't take that into consideration. You don't take into consideration the sins that you perform. However, you are very quick in judging and labeling somebody. He is not good. He doesn't pray, he's not good. So first, when you point the finger at somebody else, when you point the finger at somebody else, look at this, all the fingers, all the other four, they are directed to you. One is going this way and four are directed towards you. So look at yourself first, correct yourself first, work with yourself first, and then try to correct the others as well. And remember there is a saying, that every saint has a bad past. Every saint is somebody who is, mashallah, righteous, uplifted. Wali, they may have a bad past. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven something wrong that they have done. Now, even Umar radiallahu ta'ala, he was a person who wanted to kill the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He intended to harm the believers. However, Umar became among those who glad tidings of paradise were given to him. Glad tidings of paradise was given to him. He was one of the ten. Al-Ashrat al-Mashr al-Jannah. He was the Khalifa of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. However, in the past, he was very judgmental and ready to destroy Islam and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in other words, what I'm trying to say is, don't look down upon people because simply they may be sinning. You never know what happens to them in the future. And I'm not saying agree with their sins. I'm not saying you should feel comfortable and they don't feel comfortable because they're sinning. Definitely that shouldn't be the case. But do not look at people down. Do not look at people down because you may do some other thing and he doesn't do it. And you are automatically all of a sudden you're better. This is an evil thought. So every saint may have a bad past. And many sinners may have a good future. And brothers and sisters, at the end, I believe that we need to increase our love for all the humanity. We have to increase the love and the wish of good, the wish of khayr for all the humanity. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب اليتيم ما يحب لنفسه. None of you believes until you love for your brother that which you love for yourself. And we know this very famous hadith. However, sometimes when it comes to implementing the hadith, we fail. Even though it is a popular hadith. And if I ask people, who do you think Prophet is referring to when he says, لا يؤمن أحد أخيه, when he says the word أخيه for his brother? Until he likes for his brother that which he likes for himself. A lot of people will say, oh, the brother in Islam. The brother in Islam, or his own brother in blood. No, no. Scholars, they said that a part of this أخيه, his brother, it encompasses all the humanity. Because we are all brothers and sisters in humanity. We come from the same father and mother. This has to be recognized. So we have obligations. We have duties towards the rest of the humanities, even though they are not believers, to guide them, to bring them closer to Islam, and not to have them go far away and become our enemies. And also, being a part of being a brother in faith is your own blood brother. And also your Muslim brother, who you also have to wish the best, and you have to think the best of him, and you have to increase this love. You have to increase the love you have. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says that you will not believe until you love each other. You will not reach a full state of faith until you love each other. This is progressive thought. This is not a reactionary. So this thought removes the reactionary attitude and getting back at the people right away. When you think this way, when this is your priority in your mind of loving the people, wishing the best for the people, wishing khair for everybody, when you're preoccupied with this and with achieving that, with the ways how to achieve that, then you start staying away from being reactionary, judgmental, and arrogant. You will not be able to be judgmental because you are preoccupied with something else. You will not show pride and arrogance to the people and start arguing right away with people because you are preoccupied in achieving higher objectives, higher goals. And that's what Islam is about. And that's what we are commended in our deen. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those people who are concerned all the time, inshallah, with khayr. Who are beneficial to their own selves first, beneficial to their families, beneficial to their communities, and the ummah, generally speaking. وَآخِرُ دَعْوَانَا الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ أَلَا مِنْ أَحْسَنَ الْكَلَامِ وَأَبْلَغَ مِنْ اللَّهِ كَلَامُ اللَّهِ الْمَلِكِ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلَّامِ كَمَا قَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ فِي الْكَلَامِ بِسْمِ اللَّهِ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِندَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامُ أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فاستغفروه انه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاه والسلام على رسول الله وعلى اله وصحبه ومن والاه. نصنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليك. اللهم نصنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليك. اللهم لا تسلط بذنوبنا من لا يخافك ولا يرحمنا. يا أرحم الراحمين برحمتك يا أكرم الأكرمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. عباد الله، يقول تعالى: إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم واستغفروه يغفر لكم.